Thank you, Mr. President, my distinguished colleagues. I'm Mohammed Sani Musa, representing Niger East Electoral District, and I'm going to read the lead debate on the Firearms Act, CAP F28LFN Amendment Bill 2022. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I thank you most sincerely for the privilege to lead the debate on the general principles of this important bill. The bill seeks to repeal Firearms Control Act No. 32 of 1959. CAP F28 Laws of the Federation of Nigeria 2004 and enact the Firearms Control 2022 to prevent the proliferation of illegally possessed firearms and providing for the removal of those firearms from society and by improving control over legally possessed firearms to prevent crimes involving the use of firearms. Mr. President, my highly respected colleagues, the essence of this bill is that the existing legislation, the Firearms Control Act No. 32 of 1959, CAP F28 Laws of the Federation of Nigeria, is inherently inaccurate and simply does not meet the needs of a modern society in this very modern world. You will recall that the bill was first read on the floor of the Senate on Wednesday, 2 February 2022. The main aim of this bill is to tighten firearms control and curtail the proliferation of illegal arms and bring it in line with global best practices to effectively address some of the security challenges being currently plaguing Nigeria. The Nigerian gun, or as may also be referred as firearms, has an act that clearly spells out and defines all about firearms importation, licensing, transfer, among others. Gun laws and policies, collectively referred to as firearms regulation or gun control, regulate the manufacture, sell, transfer, possession, modification, and use of small arms by civilians. Many countries have restrictive firearms policies, while a few have permissive ones, and Nigeria is not exempted from such consistent policies and regulations. In spite of this, the country is experiencing the most devastating effects of the proliferation of illegal weapons as a result of spillover effects of the crisis in Libya and Mali, as well as unresolved internal conflicts in different parts of the country, such as the Northeast, Niger Delta, and other regions. The illicit proliferation of small arms and light weapons has had a dramatic impact on peace and security in Africa, threatening not only the existence of countries, but also the livelihoods of millions of people across the continent. From available statistics provided by the United Nations Regional Center for Peace and Disarmament in Africa, it was reported that proliferation of illicit small arms and light weapons in Nigeria has reached an alarming proportion. Analysts estimated that out of 500 million weapons that may be circulating in West Africa, 350 million, which represents 70% of such weapons, can be found in Nigeria. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, on the 31st of January 2017, the Nigerian Customs Service confirmed the interception and seizure of 661 pump action rifles imported illegally into the country from China. One can only imagine the challenging situation we will have found ourselves had such a large number of illegal arms, firearms not been intercepted. Hence, there is the need to have legislation in place that will control firearms in this country. The purpose of this bill, therefore, is to enhance the constitutional right to life and bodily integrity, prevent the proliferation of illegally possessed firearms, and by providing for the removal of those firearms from society, and by improving control over legally possessed firearms to prevent crime involving the use of firearms. C enables the federal government to remove illegally possessed firearms from the society, to control the supply, possession, transfer, and use of firearms, and to detect and punish the negligent or use of firearms, or criminal use of firearms. Establish a comprehensive and effective system of firearms control and management, and ensure the efficient monitoring and enforcement of legislation pertaining to the control of firearms. The intention of reducing the use of small arms in criminal activity, specifying weapons perceived as being capable of inflicting the greatest damage, and those most easily concealed, such as handguns and other short-barreled weapons. Persons restricted from illegal access to firearms may include those below a certain age or having a criminal record. Firearms licenses may be denied to those felt most at risk of harming themselves or others. Such persons with a history of domestic violence, alcoholism, or substance abuse, mental illness, depression, or attempts at suicide. Those applying for firearms license may have to demonstrate is what this bill seeks to do, among other things. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, it is very clear that if left unchecked, this scourge will not only jeopardize the developmental gains achieved over the last 50 years, but will also impede the nation's capacity to achieve its developmental targets. Securing the lives and property of Nigerians is very strategic to the development of our beloved country, and all necessary measures must be taken to achieve this. The Principal Act is obsolete, and using it as an instrument to tackle the 21st century security challenges is simply ineffective. This bill deserves your urgent attention. I urge you to support it for second reading. Thank you, Mr. President.
Distinguished Senator Ibrahim Hassan Hadeja, the governor.
But to also lend my support to this amendment bill, and also call on my other colleagues to ensure that this bill be given speedy passage. Please permit me to explain, because just like Senator Sani Musa said, the original bill on firearms control, though well intended, came with some gaps, which I think he's trying to fill. Mr. President, I rise to support and second this bill, and also to mention the fact that I think we should also try to ensure that that bill focuses a bit on local manufacture of firearms. Most of the sections, Mr. President, are focused on possession, on licensing, and so on and so forth. We are losing the fact that there is a very, very significant firearm manufacturing industry in Nigeria, focused on manufacture of local DN guns. Anybody that has seen our vigilantes in action will see the very long barrel DN guns that they carry. But what is more worrying, Mr. President, is that we have had instances where some of those manufacturers have adapted the capacity to manufacture more deadly weapons. I remember a gentleman that was caught in Jos, Plateau State, who was manufacturing AK-47, 100% from scratch. So, Mr. President, I think we also need to dedicate certain sections of the bill to actually focus on the banning and manufacture and the control of local manufacturing. It is everywhere. Everybody that has seen our traditional institutions during our Durbars, we see the retinue of gunmen that fire guns in the air, and like I said, to supply to local vigilantes. But smart. Now they are gaining sophistication. Smart. And I think there has to be some element smart of control in that sector, Mr. Okay. President. Thank you very much.
Is anybody against the bill?
UOB.
Those distinguished senators, a bill for an act to replace the Firearms Act number 32-1959, CAF F28, Laws of the Federation of Nigeria 2004. And to establish a comprehensive system of firearms control and provide for matters connected there with 2022 second reading.
Act repealed the Firearms Act number 32, 1959, Cap F28, laws of the Federation of Nigeria 2004, and to establish a comprehensive system of firearms control and to provide for matters connected there with 2022 second reading taken. And the bill is referred to the Committee on Judiciary, Human Rights and Legal Matters to report back within 4 weeks. Later,